Water, of late also referred to as liquid gold, is a valuable natural resource required for all forms of life on Earth. Although most of the Earth's surface is covered by water, the water available for agriculture is decreasing day by day owing to increase in population, industrialization, increase in area under agriculture and scanty rainfall causing depletion in water table. Owing to globalization of trade and economic liberalization of policies, it has become inevitable to use modern irrigation technologies in agriculture, especially in horticultural crops, to obtain higher yields of good quality produce and to earn a good revenue by the farming community. Micro irrigation system, including drip or sprinkler irrigation, is one such system where in higher yields of superior quality produce can be obtained from crops by utilizing the available water resources in a limited quantity. Drip irrigation literally means providing the required quantity of water directly to the root zone of crop plants through a network of small pipes. This is also called micro irrigation. This method of irrigation is suited for crops with wider spacing, whereas sprinkler irrigation is suitable for crops which are closely spaced. Advantages of drip irrigation: saves about 30 to 60% of water, and with the saved water, more area can be brought under irrigation. Saves labor and electricity. Enables application of the required quantity of water uniformly to all the plants at one time. Enables application of water-soluble fertilizers through water and hence savings in fertilizer costs. Controls weeds and soil erosion. Enables use of saline water for irrigation. Enables to obtain higher yields of good quality. Components of drip irrigation. There are three main components of drip irrigation systems. 1. Water source and pump. The water source could be an open well or a bore well or a canal. A pump can be installed depending on the availability of water and area to be irrigated. 2. Filtration unit. This consists of filters, pressure gauge, venturi or fertigation tank. The water is filtered by different filters before it is led into the drip system. There are mainly three types of filters, namely hydrocyclone filter, sand or media filter, and screen or disc filter. Suitable filters are installed according to the impurities found in the source of water. 3. Network of pipes. Consists of main lines, submain lines, laterals, drippers or emitters, and control valves. The diameter and length of these components is determined by the design of the system, and accordingly emitters are fixed depending upon the water requirement of the crop. Design of the system. Drip irrigation is a mechanical system which feeds water to a known number of plants under appropriate pressure ranging from 1 to 2 kilograms per square meter. Hence, one should have a thorough and sound knowledge to design a drip irrigation system scientifically by considering and adopting details about the region, topography and soil type of the land, source and quality of water, as well as the spacing, stage and age of the crop. The important criteria to be considered while designing a drip irrigation system is: the outflow from the pump should be equal to the outflow from the drip system. If the outflow from the pump is less and the area to be irrigated is more, then partitioning of the area is required. Quality of the material. Quality of the material used in different components of drip irrigation system is important because most of the time it remains on soil exposed to the climatic conditions and hence should be capable of tolerating the changing climatic conditions and last long. The materials should and must be of ISI standards with the ISI marks with the respective number of component embossed or etched on it. Points to be followed during installation. Availability of water and the amount of water required by the crop should be determined prior to installation. Water to be used in drip irrigation should be checked for its suitability before using it. Suitable pump should be installed depending on the water yield and pressure to be developed or the drip system. Normally, pressure of 1.5 to 2 kg per square centimeter is required for drip irrigation, while 3 to 5 kg per square centimeter for sprinkler irrigation. The water filters used depends on the source of irrigation water. If the source of water is a bore well with less of physical impurities, only screen filters can be installed. If the source of water is an open well or a canal, screen or disc filter along with sand filter and hydrocyclone filter has to be installed. Mains and submains should be installed in a telescopic manner, that is, pipes with a larger diameter should be connected first, followed by pipes with a smaller diameter. This facilitates to maintain uniform pressure in the system, besides reducing the cost and providing required quantum of water uniformly to all the plants. The main and submains should be buried at least 45 centimeters deep to prevent them getting damaged during cultural operation mechanically. Based on the availability of water, crop to be grown and spacing, 12 mm or 16 mm laterals should be installed. For widely spaced crops, 12 mm laterals and for closely spaced crops, 16 mm laterals can be used. Depending upon the pressure, normally 250 to 300 liters of water is discharged from a 12 mm lateral, while 450 to 500 liters of water per hour from a 16 mm lateral pipe. In the main field, laterals should always be installed across the slope. Depending on the type of crop and soil characteristics, the number of drippers and their discharge capacity is determined. Normally, for widely spaced crops, 4 drippers are provided at different places at the base, 2 drippers for crops with medium spacing, and for closely spaced crops like vegetable and flower crops, drippers are provided at every 30 to 45 centimeter intervals all along the lateral pipe. End caps should be provided at the end of each section at about 2 feet above the surface to facilitate removal of physical impurities from the drip system. For every section of the pipe, an air release valve should be connected at a height of 1 meter from the surface to prevent sucking of mud by the drippers. After connection is complete, open the end caps of all laterals in all the sections and let in water for half an hour. Later, close all the end caps of laterals and check for leakage and rectify if any. Check for stones or any sharp objects before closing the channels made for laying the drip lines. In case of heavy vehicles moving on the orchard, it is advised to bury the drip lines deeper. Management of the system. Drip irrigation is a mechanical system which performs at a certain pressure of water. If the system has to perform well for a long time, the pressure should be maintained properly. Even if good quality materials are used and installed in a scientific manner, there is a possibility of failure if the field maintenance is not proper and regular. Therefore, management of the system is of prime importance. Major problems in the drip system: clogging of the laterals and emitters, preventing the easy flow and uniform distribution of water; leakage in different components of the system; quick wear and tear of the material; damage to the components from different farm animals. Among these items, laterals and dripper are more prone to clogging. The main reason for clogging is the pressure of different physical impurities in water, that is, physical impurities like tiny sand and soil particles, organic substances, chemical impurities like calcium carbonate, salts of fertilizers, and biological impurities of microorganisms and algae. The problems encountered due to physical impurities can be overcome by proper management of the different components in the system, whereas the problems encountered due to chemical impurities and biological impurities can be overcome by acid treatment and chlorination respectively. Control of biological impurities. Management of filters. Regional type of suitable capacity filters should be compulsorily installed depending on the quality of water. The impurities collected in the filter should be cleared every day or at fortnightly or monthly interval, and it should be flushed and cleaned once in a week. Management of the section and laterals. The end caps in the sections should be opened and the system should be operated for at least half an hour to remove the physical impurities collected at the ends. Similarly, the impurities collected in the laterals can also be expelled by opening the end caps of the laterals. Control of chemical impurities. Chemical impurities can be controlled by using acid treatment and chlorination. Acid treatment. The drippers and laterals clogged by various chemical impurities, including fertilizer residues, if any, used for fertigation, can be removed by treating the system either with hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid or nitric acid. Among these, hydrochloric acid at 25% dose is best for the treatment. Method. The known amount of hydrochloric acid in water. Pump it into the system through the venturi or fertigation tanks after the system is filled with water. Allow acid solution into the system until a pH of 4 is reached both at the starting and at the last emitters. Retain this mixture for 24 hours. The acidified water in the system reacts with the salts deposited in the system and dissolves it. After 24 hours, the acidified water along with the dissolved salts comes out of the system by flushing. The following precautions should be taken during acidification. Hand gloves should be used to prevent the acid coming in contact with hands. Acid should be added to water, but not water to acid. Undirectional valves should be installed to prevent backflow of acidified water. The mixing of acid can vary depending on the output of water from the pump. The mixing of acid should be started after keeping the system in running condition and all the distribution channels are filled with water. The pH of the acidified water let into the system should be checked with a litmus paper regularly at random so as to maintain a pH of 4 throughout the system. After acidification of the system, flush the system with fresh water for some time until the acid solution is removed from the system. Chlorination. Chlorination is done to remove the biological impurities collected in the drip irrigation system. Chlorination can be done either by using calcium hypochlorite, sodium hypochlorite, chlorine or calcium hydrochloride, bleaching powder. Method. Soak the required quantity of bleaching powder in water 1 day before treatment. The decanted solution is let into the system through the venturi or fertigation tank and allow it to stay in the system for 24 hours. Later on, open the end caps of the sections and laterals. Run the system for about an hour so that the impurities are thrown out of the system. Duration and dosage of chlorine acids. Algae. Regular intervals. 1 to 2 milligrams per liter of water. Bacteria. Once in 2 to 3 months. 10 to 20 milligrams per liter of water. Complete clogging of drippers. Superchlorination once, 500 milligrams per liter of water. Control of uneven distribution of water in the system. The main reason for uneven distribution of water in the system is due to the difference in the pressure of water. A minimum pressure of 1.5 to 2 kilograms per square centimeter in drip irrigation system, while for sprinkler irrigation, minimum of 3 to 5 kilograms per square centimeter pressure should be maintained. Sometimes the water pressure reduces due to clogging of the filters. Therefore, the filters should be cleaned regularly. Prevention of leakage in different components. The different drip components and laterals should be checked regularly for leakage of water and rectified immediately. Leaky washers and laterals should be replaced with good quality new ones immediately. Ensure use of good quality products which are manufactured from a good company and has ISI certification. Avoid use of products manufactured from reusable plastics. The drip irrigation components are likely to be damaged by cattle, rats, squirrels and crabs in the field. Care should be taken while grazing cattle and the laterals should be rolled and kept aside while plowing. To control rats and squirrels, the field should be kept clean or keeping water bowls at 3 or 4 places along the drip lines will help in controlling them to a certain extent. Scientific installation of drip irrigation does not mean that there is no need of maintenance. To obtain good results, field maintenance of the drip irrigation system is a must, along with proper designing, use of good quality materials. Water requirement of different horticultural crops. The above said quantities mentioned are maximum water requirement of crops. It may vary depending on the soil type, area to be grown and rainfall of that region. Comparison of lateral pipes used in drip irrigation system. ISI lateral pipes are prepared from basic materials, whereas low-grade lateral pipes are prepared from recyclable pipes. Size and thickness of the pipes will be uniform and according to the standards specified by ISI in ISI lateral pipes, whereas size and wall thickness will not be uniform throughout in low-grade lateral pipes. The inner and outer surfaces of the pipes is smooth and does not offer any resistance to water flow in ISI lateral pipes, whereas in low-grade lateral pipes, the inner and outer surfaces of the pipes is rough and resists smooth flow of water inside. ISI lateral pipes do not crack or easily break when folded. Low-grade lateral pipes crack after folding 3 to 4 times and they can be easily broken. ISI lateral pipes are durable up to 10 years if used for 800 hours in a year, whereas low-grade lateral pipes are durable up to 6 months to 2 years. In ISI lateral pipes, since the pipes do not crack, water flow is only from where the dripper or micro tube is inserted. Whereas in low-grade lateral pipes, since the pipes crack, water flows all along the line leading to wastage of water. In ISI lateral pipes, cost of installation is high but 30% more durable than the lower grade. Whereas in low-grade lateral pipes, cost of installation is less but owing to quality of material and less durability, the investment made on it is not worth. Government subsidy is available for ISI lateral pipes, whereas for low-grade lateral pipes, government subsidy is not available for its installation. Efficient in performance and can expect assured yield and returns. Insufficient performance as the pipes are prone to cracking and can't expect assured returns. Guarantee and servicing available up to 3 years for ISI lateral pipes, whereas for low-grade lateral pipes, no guarantee of the material and no servicing is available. Material is ISI certified, whereas low-grade lateral pipes does not have any certification. In ISI lateral pipes, minimum expenditure is incurred on maintenance and repair, that is rupees 100 per acre, whereas for low-grade lateral pipes, rupees 800 to 1000 is incurred as expenditure towards repair and maintenance. From this furnished details, it is advisable to use ISI certified product for longer durability and higher returns. ISI specifications for drip irrigation components. Laterals specification. According to ISI 12786-1989, for every 15 meter length of the drip lateral pipes, the following details should be given. Manufacturer's name, pipe size, for example 12 mm, 16 mm, etc. Pipe class, example class 1, class 2. Manufacture date or batch number. Raw material used, LLDPE. Grade, PE25. ISI mark, ISI specification number 12786. Manufacturing license number CM/L with 7 numbers. Filter specification, ISI 12785-1988. Details on every filter. Manufacturer's name and address. Filtering capacity, example 10 or 20 square meters per hour. Model. Dimensions of the outer and inner fittings of the filter. Working pressure of the filter. Measure of the filter jewelry, 100 mesh, 200 mesh, etc. Serial number, ISI mark, ISI specification number 12785, manufacturing license number CM/L with 7 numbers, emitter specification, manufacturer's name, class details, A class 5% difference, B class 10% difference, rate of discharge, example 4 liter per hour, 8 liter per hour, etc. ISI mark, ISI specification number IS133487, manufacturing license number CM/L with 7 numbers. For effective utilization of water and to achieve better results in crop, adoption of drip irrigation is necessary. Use of quality materials with proper maintenance makes drip irrigation system to perform well for longer time. With drip irrigation, we can save water, which is precious for our future.